Hola, ¿cómo está? I'm going to start this stream on coloring something easy. The whole thing, it has been just color stuff. That's the whole point of this, is I just wanted to color, and it's a good excuse to do it, because I hadn't been doing the fucking thing I was supposed to be, which was, you know, actually doing Spanish stuff for a long damn time. Haven't been practicing it. So that's the idea. And I figured, go with the easiest thing. I learned a couple of fruit names, and now I'm just gonna do the easiest fuck. I'm just gonna do, like, children's book coloring pages, because that's an easy way for me to figure out what the hell is supposed to be happening. And hola is one of those words that I actually already know. Surprised or not, it's one that I do know. I'm gonna just, you know what? I'm gonna do different colors for each of the letters. See, this is like a, oh, hello, how's it going? That's a little bit weird to call me that, but, I mean, I don't mind, because I don't really care what anybody calls me, so it works out for everybody. How's it going? This is just me using a coloring tablet. Like, I've got a coloring tablet, and I'm just coloring, and I'm doing the Spanish thing again, but I'm just doing it in the easiest, cheapest way I possibly can. So I am learning the word hola today, and I might learn adios later. That'll be special if I can get to that point. These things take a lot longer to color than I would expect them to take. I'm probably just very slow at coloring things. I think I'm gonna do each one of these letters in a different color. I might as well. Going solid? Yeah, I'm doing fine. I'm also doing fine. I have been very tired the last couple of Saturdays, so I'm just making myself laugh at these things. Sitting here and coloring shit is not what I thought I would be doing when in my 30s. I never thought I'd be coloring things on camera when I was in my 30s, though it is entirely my choice, because it's not like I'm getting paid for it. It's just fun to do. This is definitely going to look more like a child's coloring book in a second when I finish doing all these letters in stupid colors. There's purple. Pixel by pixel. It is very close up, so you can see the pixels when I do it. I'm going to do things with contrast to them, like purple and orange. Then I'll put, like, something that contrasts with orange on the L in hola. I don't know what... Man, I wish I could remember what the damn colors were called. Starting with hola is a little bit earlier on in my education. I already knew what that one was. I probably should have started with, like, digging through that book and finding some colors that I could do. That way at least I'm contributing to my own stream by saying Spanish words more often. Because all I'm going to be able to do now is say stupid shit, because I can't remember any actual Spanish. Been too damn long since I practiced. I have said that every week now. Because it has been. This thing probably needs a background color too. So I probably need... why would I do that to myself? Why? If I put the pen too damn close to the top of the page, it starts to auto-scroll up that way. And that fucks me over. Orange in English, and I do not remember what it is in Spanish. I remember marrón as brown, and I'm really hoping that that is brown, because I'm probably wrong, but that's what I remember it as. Maybe my memory is more shot than I thought it was. Oranges did. We named the color after the fruit. That one's one of those facts that's getting around on the internet a lot more, so it's probably one of those things more people know nowadays. Though, I do half expect people don't even pay attention to the internet sometimes. Alright, what contrasts with orange? Kinda? Yeah, I'm making this look like such a stupid children's thing. It's not like I can do a much better job making it look like it's not a children's thing. It is a children's coloring book that says Ola in it. I don't think that I'm going to make this, like, less childish. It is just coloring shit. Man, this might as well be an IRL stream for the fact that I'm just sitting here fucking coloring on a tablet anyway. I could probably spend my time doing things that are worth more value to my life, but this is a lot funner. Funner? More fun. It's a lot more fun than I thought it was gonna be when I first started it, and I think that I might do this for the rest of my damn life. I might just sit here on Saturdays and talk at people while I do this. Even if nobody shows up, I'll probably just sit here and color stupid shit. Maybe by the end, when I'm dead, I'll actually know some fucking Spanish for once. Maybe I'll be able to memorize it. That looks so tacky and bad. I'm very happy it looks so tacky and bad. What's another bad color to put next to that? Like a burnt red. How's that? It's gonna look stupid. I want it to look stupid. I don't know that I can really make this. I don't know that I can make any of these coloring pages look good. I don't think that I would ever accomplish such a thing. Maybe one day I'll try one of them adult coloring books with all the, like, fancy shapes and shit in it. But I think that I need better color theory for that kind of thing. Otherwise, it's gonna look awful. It's just gonna look atrocious. This is already gonna look atrocious, but that's something I'm fine with. A weird legacy. I'm glad to be done with the fruit. Last week and the week before, I was coloring fruit, and that was just it was a lot more time consuming than I had assumed it would be. It seems like coloring is something that I remember as a kid going by, like, really fast. It took me no time at all. Though looking back on it, I mean, I taught kindergarten. Little kids, they take a while to color things, unless they're, like, super hyperactive and shit, and they get things done quick, because they're more about, like, getting things done rather than getting it done pretty. That might be what I did when I was a kid. I don't remember if I was really hyperactive or if I was really low. I don't remember any of that shit. It's been fucking several decades since I had to think about how I color things. I don't think I have colored anything since I was probably a little kid. I got to video games and then just kind of stuck with those from like 5 or 6 until adulthood. It's like a major part of my life that for most people seems to be like, yeah, I play games. It's like a thing. It's a hobby or something that I do on the side. Dude, I get home from work, I sit down and play video games till I go to sleep. And if I wake up early enough in the morning, I sit and do it again. Yeah, that looks the most tacky bullshit ever. And that star right there, this star is gonna have to be the brightest, dumbest yellow I can find. I'm gonna have to, yeah. First off, hold on. I'm gonna have to make a new layer. I'm gonna make a new color layer. Because, I don't want to screw up these, but I got to come up with a border color. Like, what might look good behind? Nothing's going to look good. That's not what I should be concerned about. What's going to look funny and stupid? If I just do like a pure, it's like a bright green. If I do that. Is that? Oh, that hurts my eyes. That is perfect. If it hurts my eyes, that's what it needs to be. I'm going to make the brush bigger, because if I don't, that's going to take me fucking 30 years to get done. Also, nothing's perfect. I didn't do, like, perfect shades on the purple or the orange or anything, so they're all slightly transparent, which just means that what I'm going to end up with here is, like, I'm going to end up with, like, patches in the letters where they have a weird color coming through them. I didn't realize that my goal was to, like, use this program to paint things badly. That has become the new goal. There. Do I need to color the whole border right now? No. No, I don't. I'm going to just color in a little bit more of it, and then I can come back and use the same color again. That'll be fine. Now, this star has to be a bright yellow. It's got to be, because it's the only thing that makes any sense to me. The world doesn't make sense, but that does. That's fine. I'm going to use that, and I'm going to drop the brush size back down a bit. There we go. That's the right color, I think. I'm going to assume it's the correct color, because if it's not, then, well, fuck it. I don't actually care. Hola. ¿Cómo está? I should probably get back into using the proper accent, too. Hola, ¿cómo está? Might be a good idea. Considering I talk to people sometimes who actually speak Spanish, I'd rather they not be offended by how bad the accent is. Sometimes it's a good thing for them to think, oh, he's stupid and doesn't know what the hell he's saying, because then I'd actually know what they are saying. But just because I understand Spanish doesn't mean I can fucking speak it most of the time. Somebody says a sentence to me, I can probably get it for the most part. But I gotta sit there and parse it for a minute. There. Now I gotta color this kid's eyes, because his eyes need it. The white's kind of supposed to stay white, I think. I mean, it should. Yeah, I'm gonna leave the white in the center white. Otherwise, it's just gonna look, it's gonna look wrong. Which is, I want it to look bad, not wrong. Make this kid's eyes red. If I could make them glow red, that'd be great. I don't think I got that in this program. I'm using, like, the most basic fucking program. I like it. We use it for thumbnails and shit. I just never thought about using it to actually color things or do any sort of artistic stuff. Probably should have done with this was do something funny, like instead of making the kid's eye red. Oh god, that looks really stupid. Maybe let's do there. Just a little bit. that's gruesome. I don't know why I did that. I'm going to make the other eye red too, because that's what it's supposed to be. But I'm not going to make blood drip out of this one. I don't know why I made blood drip out of the other one. I don't know why that's funny to me today. I don't know a lot of things. Being blissfully ignorant. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. But as long as I don't know what I'm talking about, I guess I can't think about it too heavily and try to overanalyze it, which is a good way to make everything stop being funny to me. There. I really need to add some more colors to this, because that's just drawing way too much attention. I need to give this kid some skin. That's the weirdest sentence I think I've ever fucking said. I need to give this kid some skin. Oh, fucking awful. There's no lines inside of his ears. There's like, his ears are they're solid, like flaps of skin rather than anything else. That's the weirdest fucking thing. Why are your ears this weird? You'd think when they do like children's books like this, I know it's for coloring stuff in, so it's not supposed to be too detailed, but giving kids basic facial anatomy feels like it's a thing you ought to do. you should make sure that kids are actually seeing the proper facial anatomy. I mean, they can be weird, like this is a nose for some damn reason, but eh, whatever. I probably ought to fix that kid's eye. I'm not gonna. I'm gonna leave his eye like that. Fuck it. But it's still funny. I should have made the brush size bigger on this. Coloring a face is gonna take a long fucking time. And I have like one of the smallest brush sizes equipped. At least I'm on a layer below the blood, so I can just like do this and the blood doesn't disappear. Yeah, there we go. I start from there and kind of curve around. I don't want to fuck up the eyes, because fucking up the eyes will make this thing look weird to me. It's already going to look weird. That's the point. I got to figure out some like basic words in Spanish that I use all the time, like weird? I gotta figure out weird. Strange? I'm gonna figure out, should probably figure out, like, irony? I am coloring in a children's coloring book, so I doubt any of those words are here in this. This is page 1. Page 2 is adios. And page 3 is el maestro. And page 4 is la maestra. So they're just trying to, like, get the gender stuff in right next to each other when they change the word so that you can get both of those learned. That'd probably actually help me a long time ago. I lost days and come you lost data. You know, I mean, the bloody eye thing is a bit strange, so I'm sorry you had to miss all of that and then come back to it, but I guess I'm not really sorry. Not really sorry. I like the bloody eye. It's a weird addition, but I like it. It's like I can't really describe that. It is very funny to me to give characters like really strange colored eyes. So I was thinking I'd give them purple, but then red became funnier to me and I kept going with purple. Red, not purple. Why did I say purple so many damn times there? Purple is a funny word. That's why. One of those words that if I get it stuck in my head, I will end up with echolalia. That's just going to happen. No avoiding it sometimes. There's words that just do that to you. This kid. Cartoon kids. All cartoon kids seem to have like really big fucking heads and big faces. And he's a cartoon, so he's got a big head. I'm wondering, like, right now, because I'm on autopilot for the face. There's no special stuff or anything like that. So I'm kind of wondering what color his hair's going to be. What color I ought to do the speech bubble in. Because the speech bubble is, I mean, the letters aren't going to be colored like Ola. But the speech bubble itself I got a color in. Could stay white, but that feels wrong somehow. Feels wrong to leave something white. Considering I'm supposed to be making this look horrifying. I'm trying to go like just a little bit too far with everything. And if I go just a little bit too far, it'll look Uncanny Valley. No, it won't look Uncanny Valley. It'll just... Why did I do that? I want it to look mildly horrifying, like some sort of weird children's horror book, what I'm going for. That's another one I ought to learn the Spanish for, horror. I need weird, I need irony, I need horror. I probably need a bunch of other words in Spanish to properly use my vocabulary, because I broaden my vocabulary in English far too much. And that's one of my issues for trying to learn other languages, is that my vocabulary in English feels like it's sufficient to explain what I want, or explain what I want to explain. And then when I go into other languages, I forget the most basic fucking words, And in the more complex words that I want to use, I just don't know them, so I can't do anything about it. Very frustrating. And I feel like this is going by. Oh, man, seriously? Damn, I've been going for 20 minutes. Again, it always feels like when I'm sitting here coloring, I go by, a time just slips away from me. To me, it feels like I started 5 minutes ago and I've been going for 20 minutes. It's probably the opposite on the other end because it's just watching an old man color things. But, I mean, old man sitting and coloring things is entertaining enough to me, obviously. Otherwise, I wouldn't be doing it. Though watching me doing it's probably not as entertaining as doing it myself. I don't think I'd want to sit and watch me do this. Maybe I'd sit and talk to myself, though. That is generally what I do. What I'm doing right about right now. I'm still thinking about the hair color. Could do like Jacksepticeye at one point did that, like bright green. Maybe I ought to do that one. I can go with I made the eyes bright red, so I can't do that. Go purple. Give them like a blonde streak. Now I can't do brown hair because it'll clash. I don't want to do that. Maybe I could do a darker brown hair. Or blonde. All blonde. That'd be weird. Doesn't need natural hair color, and he's not going to get natural hair color because nothing I do is going to look natural. That's an important thing to remember. It's all going to look really unnatural and wrong. I should have probably just used the damn bucket tool. I probably should have. I'm not gonna. Cheating. I'm trying to sit. I'm having a good time sitting here and coloring. But it does feel like because I'm coloring this one thing for so long that I'm not going to get around to the rest of this stuff. When I was thinking, like, maybe I could go pretty quick and get, like, two pictures done. Two children's book pictures done today. I don't know that I'm going to get two of them done today. I don't know that that's going to be able to happen. Ridiculous. It is satisfying making these like little corners and then just filling them in. I like doing that. Coloring is... I don't know if coloring's like calm or anything. I don't know if I'd say I calm down with it. I generally wouldn't want to... I wouldn't want adult coloring books for my normal everyday life. Because I'd probably rather sit and do something like play a game for... achievements or something like that. I'd probably rather sit and play something, have my mind be engaged. Right now, my mind is engaged in... Actually, my mind is not very engaged right now. I think being tired is why I decided to just do coloring books a couple weeks ago. I haven't been very awake since probably about 3 or 4 weeks ago. I think there was a day back then where I had some energy, but I haven't had any in a bit. Side effects, as it were. It happens. I need to get to a point where I can actually sleep again for a little while, and maybe I won't be so damn tired all the damn time. Well, at least that was a fuck-up that wasn't too bad. It didn't go anywhere. That was a fuck-up that didn't fuck up too bad. I should probably give this kid, like, facial hair. That makes sense. Add things to it. Don't just color. Give some sort of extra. I had a kindergarten teacher, just wanted us to color things, and then I had a first grade teacher who said that she didn't like the idea of first graders coloring. We needed to learn. So if we were going to have art time... she'd give us coloring pages, but then we'd also have to give some sort of substance to the picture. You gotta add something. Can't just color. So you gotta like draw things in. Last week somebody stopped by and had me draw SpongeBob next to the Pina. And because they had me draw SpongeBob on there, I actually added something to that coloring book page. This kid needs something. And I don't think the blood was as kind to the picture. Kind. I don't know why I was thinking kind is even important in this case. But cartoon kid, I'll give him a mustache. Maybe I'll give him some stubble. We'll see about that once I actually color his face all the rest of the way in. I want to know, after I've finished coloring his face in, what the facial hair might look like. And it's not going to look good unless I can see it against his face fully colored in. Oh, and his neck. I almost forgot that he had a neck. Most people have necks. At least some people don't, but I know most people do. And I've got to do the stubble in the same, like, sort of color as hair. Or you know what? I could just do the stubble in, like, little black lines. Because little black lines apply stubble in any hair color. So I could probably do that and it wouldn't be noticeable. Oh man, those red eyes make it kinda nightmarish. Kinda. I should probably amend that. I need to color his hair. It's bugging the shit out of me. Damn. What color hair am I gonna give you? What hurts my eyes the most? Oh, and what haven't I used? You know what? Fuck it. It's not about what I haven't used. I'm gonna go with a very wrong color. Very, very wrong. Yeah, that's your hair color now. You are gonna be, your hair is made out of cotton candy because I am stupidly tired. Yeah, that's canon. This kid's hair is made out of cotton candy and his parents work at a carnival. There was a carnival accident, and he became a superhero. His superpower is that his hair is made out of cotton candy. That's his life now. I don't know if he's Cotton Candy Man. That wouldn't be... Candy Man is already a horror villain, so maybe something a little bit less... Horror? I was going to try and do horror anyway because his eye is bleeding. Instead of his nose bleeding, like all those psychics in movies, when he does his powers, if he goes like too hard, he pushes himself to make too much cotton candy hair. He pushes himself too damn hard and his eye bleeds. So he pops some blood vessels in his eyes when he was trying to grow his cotton candy hair out because his parents needed more cotton candy for their stand at the carnival. What have I done with my life? Where's my life gone? Oh, God. I think that's probably a decent representation of where I feel like my life is going. I'm making up random stories about Spanish coloring book children. The saga of... I gotta give the kid a name. Kid's gotta have a name. A girl has a name. Is that phrase from Song of Ice and Fire? No, a girl has no name and then she took her name back. That was what it was. So, this kid's gotta have a name. What kind of name am I gonna give Cotton Candy Kid? That's a good superhero name. Cotton Candy Kid? I think that's his superhero name. I'm gonna have to add that down to the bottom somewhere. Every time I zoom out, it scares me slightly. Oh, man. I don't normally write my T's like that, but with the word cotton, I feel like it needs to be written that way. Cotton. Candy. I need that, like, little lilt on the end of the letters. Cotton. Candy. Kid. Yeah. it's absolutely. All right, go ahead. I am having I having too much fun. Oh, man. God. Why is this so fun? Cotton Candy Kid. I mean, I need a normal name, too. It's a Spanish coloring book. Maybe he ought to have a Spanish name. I don't know. First names that come to mind are students that I have. I don't think that's very kind of me. I should probably give the Cotton Candy Kid should probably have a unique name. Right? I mean, seems only fitting. Cotton Candy Kid is... What? Oh, come on, man. Like, all I can think of is students' names. That ain't cool. Coming up with a Spanish name is hard when I'm not used to hearing Spanish names except for my students. That seems incredibly unfair. It's what apparently happens to a lot of new parents, or not new parents, but like people who are expecting. So I guess it's called expecting parents. They go through this process of trying to name their kid before the kid's born. They run across a bunch of names, and then they argue about, like, no, I knew a guy with that name, or I knew a lady with that name, and I don't like that person, so I definitely don't want to name my kid that, because that would be incredibly annoying. Like, I get that. I understand that. And in this case, I don't want to name this kid the Cotton Candy Kid. I don't want to name Cotton Candy Kid something that a student already has. This is going to be a tough one. I got a bit to figure it out, because it's obviously taken me a while to make all of his damn hair. Too much cotton candy. That's what's going on here. I mean, I could look at, like... No, I don't want to look at... I don't want to name the kid after somebody. I don't know who I would name the kid after anyway, but... They'd probably end up being offended, considering the whole point of this is that I wanted to make the kid look... I wanted to make the picture, not the kid. I wanted to make the picture look as crazy and painful to the eyes as possible, which is why cotton candy hair is what you end up with, because it hurt my eyes to see it. Ignacio? I don't think I have a student named Ignacio. I don't think I've got a student named... I don't have any students named Miguel. I got students named Michael, though. Make me think of my student's name Michael. I don't want to do that. J names and M names are the only ones that come to mind. Oh, you know what? I had a friend back in high school. Hispanic family. Maybe I'll name the kid after him. If I can't come up with anything by the end of this stream to name the Cotton Candy Kid, I'll just name it after my friend from high school. I don't think I've spoken to him in more than a decade at this point. I don't even know if I would have considered us friends in high school. God, it is still so fucking painful to look at. I want it to be, and I'm glad that it is. I got like a skin layer. That's such a weird thing to say. Oh, man. Doing anything like this makes me feel weird every time I say anything. Skin layer is weird. And this kid has fucking three fingers. Three fingers. Maybe I ought to give him four fingers. It's not very evenly spaced. And I think I'd be really bad at drawing fingers anyway. Plus, if I was really good at drawing fingers and I could do like a good hand, then it would be like a super realistic hand. On a picture, I don't think that's a good idea. I couldn't accomplish anything like that, so I don't know why I was thinking about it, but I couldn't make it look even as good as it is now, and I think it looks freaky right now. Give you your thumb. So Cotton Candy Kid popped a blood vessel, or all of the blood vessels in both of his fucking eyes. He popped all of the blood vessels in both of his eyes while he was trying to grow his cotton candy hair so that his parents could have more cotton candy at their cotton candy stand at the carnival that they work at. Don't have any more to that story. Like, this kid's got no origin story other than let's say he fell into a toxic vat of cotton candy. What is a toxic vat of cotton candy? I mean, he fell into a toxic vat of cotton candy. I can't say anything else about it. That's gotta be what happened. Cotton Candy Kid fell into a toxic vat of cotton candy. That's all I know. What is, like, I mean, I don't want to use more red, and red makes like a normal sense with this, so I'm gonna go with like blue. Oh wait, that's the skin layer. I don't want to do that. There we go. Yeah, that'll be fine. I could probably add something to his shirt, too, that would make sense, but I don't know what makes sense with the star thing. I don't have any logos or anything like that that makes sense with the star. Like, all I can think of with a star like this is the more you know, and I don't think I can really accomplish coloring the rainbow properly and having all of the depth that the rainbow on that symbol is supposed to have and all those things. Feel like it would just look not bad in the way I want this to look, but bad in a way that I don't want it to. I hope that makes sense. I know it doesn't, but I hope it does. Because if it doesn't make any damn sense, well, I'm not clarifying. I don't care to sit here and try to justify the stupidity that comes out of my mouth. Word vomit is all I have. Don't take from me all that I have. It's all I got. Steal my word vomit. Sounds mean. It also sounds incredibly gross. I think I should probably stop using the term. Never gonna. That's one of those terms that I use way more often than I probably ought to. Word vomit. It's what happens when somebody comes in and tries to present a project and they have no idea what they're talking about. Like, I'm going to wing it. I'm like, all right, if your partner wanted to wing it, you'd be fine. But you wanting to wing it, you suck at winging things. So you're not going to do a good job on this project. Which is probably what happened here with what I'm doing. I decided to wing every aspect of this kid. I did not think about anything ahead of time when I absolutely should have. I should have thought about, what color is that star gonna be? I should have planned out, done like a swatch, done a color swatch on every part of this kid. Planned out what colors were going to be here and everything else. But you know what? Life is, I couldn't even try there. I was going to go for some, like, bullshit philosophy, but I had none in the barrel. None in the chamber. That's the phrase. I don't know why I said barrel. Like I was going to shoot myself with philosophy. I think I could probably shoot myself with philosophy. I don't feel like that'd be all that hard to do. I'm pretty damn sure lots of people shoot themselves with philosophy. Usually it's either in the foot or in the head and nowhere in between. Shot myself in the foot with my philosophy. Your life philosophy is filled with racism, sexism, and moron. Moron? Moronity. Moronity? I don't think that's a word either. Stupidity. Your life philosophy is stupidity and racism and sexism. And perhaps you should have thought about it. There is an ice cream truck driving by my apartment. It is a weird time of day for that. It seems incredibly weird to drive an ice cream truck by a place at this time of day. Like, what the why would you do that? You gotta come by when kids are actually outside, because adults cannot be your target market with that, can they? Adults might buy ice cream all the damn time. I know as soon as I started getting money as an adult, I bought like a shitload of food and thought I can finally actually buy all the food I want to buy and make whatever I want to make. I'm sure lots of adults thought the exact same thing with several gallons of ice cream, but it feels a bit odd for an ice cream truck to have the target audience be adults. So I'm thinking it's probably kids, but that seems like a weird thing during a Saturday to think about kids playing out in the street in the evening. Because kids should be playing out in the street during the middle of the day when all of the adults are sleeping still, because we all sleep in on weekends. At least I did. God, I slept way longer than I wanted to. I should have slept until like fucking 7 a.m. or something like that, and I slept until 10. Which is not sleeping in by my old standards. Sleeping in by my old standards was like I was asleep at fucking 4 p.m. And I didn't wake up until like fucking 4:30, 3:35, something like that. It was my old standard of waking up late, sleeping in. Nowadays, I got responsibilities, and my body thinks you've got to be responsible and wakes me up. You know, I kind of like the white sleeves, but then I don't like the white background, and I planned on keeping the background white. Motherfucker. I gotta make the sleeve. I don't want the sleeves to be this blue. I'm gonna change that. Make this a darker blue. That ice cream truck must be selling to somebody outside, because they just decided to stop out there. I don't know if it's getting picked up on the capture, but I'm certainly gonna comment on how annoying it is that somebody decided to park an ice cream truck outside while I'm doing something that requires me to record things with a microphone. And the microphone can possibly pick up a loud fucking noise, like an ice cream truck song. What a dickhead. I shouldn't be upset. People are trying to sell ice cream. It's like that Rupert Grint guy. Just want to make people happy. Just want to make people have a good time, make people smile, make people happy. I shouldn't be curmudgeonly about it. I am coloring, so I definitely shouldn't be. This kid's got a lot of blue streaks in his shirt. That's because my tablet has a lot lower of a light level. I should probably make it way brighter. I'm gonna make this tablet screen real fucking bright. Or disconnect it entirely. Shit. I think I might have. Well, damn. Alright then. If I do something real stupid, like completely shut off the only piece of technology that I can use to do the thing that I'm doing. Well, it knows. There we go. I might as well go ahead and make the whole thing very angry. There we go. It's very angry at me and has decided that it does not like what I'm doing. So, I'm going to have to use. Yeah. All right. This is really weird. Now the tablet is off entirely, but I'm using the capture on a different screen and just coloring with that, which feels really weird. I don't like it. I'd rather be looking at what I'm coloring. It's actually going a bit slower because of it. Well, I shouldn't screw myself over like that. Have to figure out what I broke and how I broke it and then fix it for next week. Because if I, actually, I'd have to fix it for today. I use this thing for a lot of stuff besides coloring. And so it's a bad thing to just break a fucking drawing tablet. When I turned it off and turned it back on, it was like, hey, here you go. And then it gave me my picture, and then it immediately fucking shut off again. That's what I get for being mad at the ice cream man. You get mad at the ice cream man, and this is what happens to you. Your shit's just like, look, you're too much of an asshole. I'm not going to keep working, because if I keep working, I'm going to get called an asshole too. Can't work for somebody this terrible. Well, I can't fucking blame you. Almost done with this kid's sleeve. There we go. There. I should probably do, like, all the rest of this stuff properly. But I don't want to make this a lot longer. So you know what? The kid's name is going to be Romero. He is Romero, the cotton candy kid. That's what it is. That's probably what this whole thing is. Romero the Cotton Candy Kid. I wonder if every other one is going to end up being a superhero. I hope not. I should probably do more creative stuff than making everybody a fucking superhero, right? Anyway, hope you enjoyed it. Hope you come back for the next one, which is going to be me doing the rest of Hola, possibly. Or I'll give up on this and move on to Adios. So, hasta luego. Adios.